What is going on, you guys? Rebel Gaming back with another video, and we're on something a little bit different. We're gonna be on Car Mechanic Simulator 2015. I wish they would make a new one of these because I do enjoy this game. I've played it before, but this is the first time I have it on this PC, so we're gonna do the tutorial. Why not? Let's go for it. First customer, do you hear the phone ringing? It could be a new customer. Go to the desk and pick up the phone and check to see what needs to be done. Alright, so let's go do it. Grab the phone. In this menu, you can view all your waiting orders. Some of them are locked because you need more XP to take them. Here you can take, or if you don't like them, past jobs without consequences. New jobs will appear here every time new customer calls you. Okay. So we're gonna go ahead and take it. So we're gonna make some money, get some XP, and we are going to do some shit. That's a nice car. That's a nice car. Alright, so let's go ahead and move this. Work management. Always keep your workplace clean and organized. Repairs requiring access to wheels and suspension will only be possible on the lifter. Others can be done elsewhere. To take a new job, you need some clear space in the middle of your workshop so the client can leave their car there. Okay, so we're gonna put him on the lift. Raise. I don't know what's wrong with it. I forgot to look. Let's go and look at the order. Repair order. Here you can see details of your order. If you don't like the job or cannot perform all the tasks, you can always end the job. You will get a refund for the tasks you've already done, but you'll miss the bonus for finishing the job. In future, the orders will be more demanding and you will have to locate the broken part yourself instead of having them written on the list. Please note, the minimum part condition bar on the right shows you the minimum part condition required to fulfill each order. So the minimal condition is 67% on this one. Sway bar front end link, that is nothing. So let's go ahead and lift it. So we're gonna go ahead and order this part. Go here. Wrong one. So we need a sway bar front end link. I don't know if it's A or B. Order A. We need this one, $29. Y'all hold on a goddamn second. Alright, so let's see. Alright, so it's gonna be that right there. You can see how it's discolored there. Part disassembly. In this mode, you can unmount parts from the car. Each part can only be accessed from a particular section of the car, so if you're looking in the wrong place, you won't be able to unmount the part. Always check if the part is accessible. By moving the cursor over it, if a part is blocked by another part, it will glow red when you try to unmount it. Okay. So let's go and pull this off. There goes our tire. Now let's pull this off. We've already purchased the part. So let's go to assembly mode. Parts assembly. In this mode, you can mount parts in their places. A transparent part silhouette will appear when the part can be mounted. Okay, so just like that, you can see it there. Let's go and mount it. I'm gonna mount this. Remember, our condition is 69. So. And then we'll throw this on as well. Now, any beat up parts I am going to keep that are at a reasonable damage because I can throw them on other cars. that don't require any. So any part, it's got a decent thing. I will leave because I can use them later. So, all right, so this car is done. It was that easy. So we're gonna finish the job. Now, for my inventory, I have this here. I can go and sell that for $4. I'm gonna do it. It was very low. So we can't do these yet. Sloppy steering. Let's go and take that. So it looks like we're doing a lot of suspension. So, let's go and move this to lift. And we'll go and accept the other one and put it on the other lift. So, we're going to put this on the other lift. We'll go one to the other and see what we can't do for it. Let's go ahead and move it to that lift right there. So we're going to do this first. Let's open our hood and go to our order. It's going to be an outer tri-rod, which isn't anything. Jesus Christ. So it's gonna search outer. So we're gonna pick up an outer tri-rod. And let's get this up in the air. While that one's raising, we're gonna get this one raised. Alright, so the outer tie rod that we have to replace, you can see how that's brown. So it's gonna be this one right here. So it's gonna take the lug nuts off, take the outer tie rod off, go to assembly, and we're gonna put this, the new one on. Put the wheel on. And this one. It's done. Now over to this one. Front drive axle C, front wheel hub. Front drive axle C. Front wheel hub. Alright, so this one's costing a little bit of money. Lower suspension arm and sway bar rear end link. So lower suspension arm. And then a sway bar. I don't know which one it is. Oh, it's a sway bar rear end link. I thought it was a front. Alright, so let's go get these items put on. So this one's going to take a little bit of work. We have to replace this. And a few more items. So get these to replace. So this side's the worst. Which is okay. Not going to be too awfully bad here. Let's go and pull the brake off. Pull the brake pad off. Pull the bearing out. Pull the hub off. Alright, so let's go ahead and start installing this side back together. Got a nice new shiny hub. Go ahead and throw the disc back on. Throw the bearing back in. Put that on. Put the brake back on. Alright, so we're just gonna finish tightening up the wheel. And let's go to this side. So now, we gotta pull this wheel off. And we gotta pull off the lower control line. So let's go and throw the new one on. Nice and shiny. Now I'm going to be getting mods for this game that I don't have yet, but I will be getting them. Because why not, you know? So now back here, we're going to be looking at. Right there is the part that we have to replace. Let's get this wheel off. Now it takes a little bit of time to be able to use, to be able to go buy cars and things like that. It's a lot of XP that you need. So, that might take a few episodes before we are able to do that kind of thing, but we will get it done. And this one is done. So, let's go and finish that job. Collect our money. I got a few parts we can sell. Some sell for some money, some don't, and that's okay. Alright, so now, let's see what else we have. Bam. So we can't do these yet. Let's go and do timing. Timings are pretty fun. Get to go into the timing cover and shit. Just a little bit different, a little bit different than suspension. So let's go and move it over to the left. Tensioner, timing belt, and water pump. Alright, so let's go and pull the tensioner off. Serpentine belt, serpentine belt. I'm gonna pull the water pump off. Now we have to get into the timing cover. So we're gonna pull the alternator off. And pull the crankshaft pulley off, pull the idler roller off, and pull out the timing cover. Now in here, we have the timing belt. That's gotta come off. Then we need a tensioner, timing belt, water pump 14. So here, water pump 14. Tensioner. Timing. So it's just this basic timing belt. Now let's go put parts back on. Now this game does get more difficult, you guys. More complicated builds and things of that nature. This is just the beginning of the game to get used to it. But it gets to the point where you're pulling everything off the car and rebuilding the entire car. So they will get more interesting, I promise. So just stick around. But I do gotta tell you guys, if you guys do like this series, let me know. And I'll keep doing them. Just throw a like and leave a comment. Comment down below what the first car I should buy, because at some point I will buy cars and refurbish them and keep them in my own little garage. So that's one thing to look forward to. So I'm gonna take you guys' requests first on which cars I should buy. Make sure you guys let me know that. So let's see what else we got. Engine power has failure. Alright. We're going to do this suspension first. Because that's the first one that came in. Always got to do it in order of when they come in. Alright. So let's go and move this over to the left. I know it's a suspension. So I know it's going to need to be over here. And we're going to go and raise it up. Alright, well, I can see one thing right now. Huh. Well, that wheel's got to pretty much come off completely. What we going to need? A front spring, front steering knuckle A. Front spring, steering knuckle A. Let's see what else we need. Inner tie rod. Rear suspension arm. It's a rear suspension arm A. And I need a rubber bushing. I think it's a normal one that I need. And I think an inner tie rod. Yep. And then we'll get started on it. Inner tie rod. Alright, let's get into this car. So, right here's the spring that needs to come off. So we gotta pull the wheel off. I mean, on this one, we gotta pull a nice majority of this front end apart. to get the parts off that we need. My damn alarm went off again. So, let's go and pull that off. Now I'll pull this off. Pull this out. Pull this off. And pull this off. Let's go and reassemble. Reassemble this side with our new parts. That says that. Go to this side. And we're gonna pull this stuff apart. So this is gonna be the last vehicle in this episode. Once we're done with this one, it will be the end of the video. There will be another one coming out. There's basically gonna be a pattern to these videos, you guys. They're gonna go in order. Do one, then do the next, and like in the all the different games I'm doing. We're gonna do one game, one episode, one game, one episode, one game, one episode, until we go through all the games for the first episode. And then we will be just do the same thing with episode two. So we are literally having to pull most of the front end on both sides off to get this part on. This is the part that can take a little bit. So it was all for that one part. So let's go and throw everything back on. It's kind of like car, my summer car, a little bit different, as in, this one's a little bit easier. My summer car, you have to, I'm not going to say you have to know something about cars, but it helps. This one just kind of does it for you, so, which isn't a bad thing, I guess. Why did I have like two of these? Did I like forget to put that back on the car? I think it goes in the other side, actually. It's off this car, it's just off that side. See? Right there. So we'll put that on here in a second. Right after we get this put back together. And then we'll go, I believe we have a rear, something in the back of the car we have to put on as well, so. We will go ahead and do that as well. I may not record everything, like I'll record most things, but I might skip some stuff with the actual videos on what we throw in the videos, because just save some time so we can get to the fun stuff. So I'm trying to see if I can do visually which bushing I have to replace, but that's not right there. So you can kind of see how it's like brown on this bushing, and it's not on the other one. So that's the bushing that we've got to replace. Now we have to come over here. And we have to pull the back apart to get that put on. Now this, the back's a little bit easier to get to it. Just like that. So we pull these out. And we put these back in. Get the cap and the tire. Coming. You can do it. So I'll record everything. I don't know if I'll actually upload everything or not, but it is what it is. Alright guys, so this is the end of this episode. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. If you want to see more of this series, spam that like button. Show your support for it. And yeah, we can change stuff. It's so cute. But let me know in the comments if you like this series. And if you do, I'll keep doing it. Until then, you guys, we will see you guys later. Until the next time, have a good one.